Hello everyone, SSC has released the notification for the CGL exam. In this video, let us have a look at the important dates, eligibility criteria, exam pattern and the expected cutoff. According to the notification, forms can be filled from 5th of May to 4th of June. The Tier 1 exam is scheduled to take place from 25th of July to 20th of August. People who qualify the Tier 1 exam will appear for the Tier 2 exam. The Tier 2 exam is scheduled to take place from 27th of November to 30th of November. SSC uses the cumulative scores of Tier 1 and Tier 2 exam to shortlist candidates for the Tier 3 exam. The tentative dates for the Tier 3 exam and Tier 4 exam has not been released yet. The Tier 3 exam is a descriptive test and the Tier 4 exam is conducted only for certain posts. The Tier 4 exam is purely of qualifying nature. Let us have a look at the eligibility criteria. The eligibility criteria varies according to the post. The age of the candidate as on 1st of August is used for all practical purposes. The age limit for most of the Group B posts is 30 years and most of the Group C posts is 27 years. There are some exceptions to this. Applicants can check out the notification in the description box given below to know the age limit for the post they are vying to apply for. The applicant should be a graduate. Final year students can also apply provided they manage to complete their graduation before 1st of August. The application fee is Rs. 100 for general and OBC candidates. The application fee is waived off for candidates belonging to SC, ST, PWD categories and women. Let us have a look at the pay scale for various posts. Only two posts are gazetted, Assistant Audit Officer and Assistant Accounts Officer. The grade pay for these two posts is 4,800. The Indian salary for these two posts turns out to be around 48,000 per month. For most of the Group B posts, the grade pay varies from 4,200 to 4,600 and the Indian pay varies from 40,000 to 46,000. For most of the Group C posts, the grade pay varies from 2,400 to 4,200 and the Indian salary for these posts varies from 29,000 to 40,000. Let us have a look at the pattern of the exam. The exam is conducted in 4 tiers, Tier 1, Tier 2, Tier 3 and Tier 4. Let us have a look at the pattern of the Tier 1 exam. The Tier 1 exam consists of 4 sections: General Intelligence and Reasoning, General Awareness, Quantitative Aptitude and English Comprehension. Each of these sections carry 25 questions and each question carries 2 marks. Half a mark is deducted for every wrong answer. The paper in total carries 100 marks and the time allotted for the paper is 1 hour. There are no sectional cutoffs or sectional time limits in this paper, so aspirants can use their section of strength to maximize their score. Let us have a look at the pattern of the Tier 2 exam. The Tier 2 exam consists of 4 papers. Paper 1 is Quantitative Aptitude, Paper 2 is English Language, Paper 3 is Statistics and Paper 4 is General Studies. All aspirants must take Paper 1 and Paper 2. Paper 3 is for candidates who have applied for the post of Junior Statistical Officer and Paper 4 is for candidates who have applied for the post of AAO and AO. Quantitative Aptitude section consists of 100 questions. Each question carries 2 marks. Half a mark is deducted for every wrong answer. The time limit for attending the paper is 2 hours. Paper 2 is English Language. The English language paper contains 200 questions. Each question carries 1 mark. It is pen and paper based. The Tier 3 exam contains an essay, letter writing or quiz writing. Usually options are given, but last year no option was given to the candidates in choosing the questions. The Tier 3 exam is for 100 marks and the time allotted for the Tier 3 exam is 1 hour. The Tier 4 exam is conducted only for certain posts. The data entry skill test is conducted for applicants who applied for the post of tax assistant. The computer proficiency test is conducted for applicants who have applied for the post of assistants in various ministries. In the CPT, aspirants have to demonstrate their abilities in word processing, spreadsheet processing and creating PowerPoint presentations. Let us have a look at the cutoffs in the past. Last year, the cutoff for Tier 1 exam was 126.5. 2 years back, the cutoff was 137. The drastic reduction in cutoff is due to the fact that SSC decided to shorten the exam by 15 minutes. This year, we can expect the cutoff for Tier 1 exams to be around 130, the level of difficulty remains the same. To shortlist candidates for the Tier 3 exam, SSC uses the cumulative scores of the candidates. In 2016, the marks one has to score to appear in Tier 3 was 422. This year, we expect the marks to be around 430, factoring in the increased competition. The cutoff for final selection for any post in 2016 was 514. As we can see, aspirants must score as high as possible in Tier 1 and Tier 2 exams. If they score less, they will have to score extremely well in the Tier 3 exam to compensate the marks. Aspirants must try to score at least 20 to 30 marks above the cutoff to be on the safer side. The final cutoff for top posts can go as high as 590 out of 100. To help you with the preparation process, we are providing a lot of resources for free. We are providing 18,000 solved questions, a free mark, and the past year papers of all SSC CGLs. The links for the same can be found in the description below. Please like and share this video and subscribe to our channel to receive more updates on SSC CGL and other bank exams.